Hello everyone, my name is Joseph Campanelli. I'm a student here at the maintenance program at SUU. Today we're going to be talking about the different general toolboxes that you guys have offered up to you by the school and different sets of tools that you may be using while on different projects. Let's get started. All right, to start off, we have our general toolbox here. We're going to start from the top and just work our way down and talk about the general tools and different things you may be using them for. So to start off at the top here, we have our handsaw. So we use a fine tooth handsaw so that way we don't damage the different metal components that we'll be working on in the projects. Again, you have your general open end and box end wrenches here that you will be using on the different engines that we have available to you to work on. And then we have our Allen keys. So these Allen keys are nice because you have these rounded ends, which allow you to get into specific angles that you may be tight in certain areas on the engine. We also have our different sets of pliers here. So a lot of these are for your electrical uses or safety wire. So we got our electrical cutting, stripping, and crimping tool here, as well as different safety wire pliers, cutting tools, and of course your needle nose for gripping different types of wire. So the top drawer here, we have again some of our general basic tools, so like screwdrivers, both Phillips and flathead, and again we have smaller sizes as well for those electrical components that you may need to work on. And then we have filing tools. So these files are again used for your metalworking, filing down edges after you may cut them or strip them or do whatever you need to do to make sure you got a nice smooth edge. The next drawer here, again, we have general tools that you're gonna be using on different projects, mainly on the engines here while inside the shop in the hangar. You got our different socket sets, angle swivel joints, which are nice, again, for those different angles that you may need to get into, different extensions, ratchets, and then you also have your mag lights to get in to inspect different areas of the engine. And that pretty much covers this drawer. Next drawer, we have, again, some of your different cutting tools for sheet metal work that you may be doing inside the lab. Larger scissors for those bigger, thicker pieces of metal, and then again, pliers for gripping that piece of metal that you may be working on. But again, with some of these pliers, you have a lot of teeth that you're gonna need to protect that piece of metal with, so you're gonna need to put a rag or some kind of shop cloth in there to make sure you don't damage your metal. The last drawer here, we have all your different type of shaping tools and marking tools for your metal as well, so your punches, your hammer, ball pin hammers, and then your larger wrenches or adjustable wrenches for different maintenance and fasteners that you need to use those on. And then you have your chisels, as well as sharp cutting edges, again, for the fabrics you may be using with your composite materials. So you need that nice razor sharp edge to cut some of that fabric. And then lastly, you have your inspection tools, your mirrors, again, that can extend again to tight spots, as well as cleaning tools like your bristle brushers or metal brushes that again are just for cleaning off certain specific components. So that's our general toolboxes. Those are your basic toolboxes you're going to be able to use, and then we have other larger boxes that are going to be able to compensate for the other tools that you may need, like where we have our standard SAE, which is the Society of Automotive Engineer standard tool set. You have your metric tools in here as well with different types of bits that you can use for those specialty fasteners that you need to get it taken off. So that's essentially these two major boxes that you'll be using while in the program at SUU. All right, so we're gonna be talking about some of these different specialty tools, inspection tools, service tools, as well as measurement tools we have here available to you at SUU during your program. So the reason we want to talk about some of these because sometimes there are specialty items that are designed specifically to take off certain components. So these are for the jugs or the cylinders that you're going to be working on certain reciprocating engines, and you're going to have to get into certain tight spots to get to those fasteners. Another item is the compression rings wrench. So you're going to need to use that to put onto the pistons and compress those rings to reinsert the piston back into the cylinder when you go to reinstall. So when we move over here, we have an inspection tool, which is your borescope here. So this is very useful when you find damage inside of an engine or when we're inspecting certain components inside the engine when we don't want to tear it apart. What we can do is open up an inspection port and feed this through and then be able to see what was on the screen in that area we're trying to inspect. As we move over here, we have some of the servicing tools for different readings, so pressure gauge for tires, as well as tension gauges for the different rigging tools that we're going to be doing on the aircraft for certain projects. When we move up here, we have the different thread gauges. This is for the different types of fasteners that you may be using for either shear or tension, which is for those finer threads or thicker thread fasteners, to ensure that you're going to find the right thread per inch for finding a torque for those types of fasteners. Another measurement tool we have is thickness gauges for those clearances in between two different components. For proper engine maintenance, you may need to make sure there's a certain clearance between blades, like on some of our turbine engines. Another measurement tool, which we can use pretty much on any outside or inside diameter, is our vernier calipers, and they go down to, I believe, 100 or 1/1000ths of an inch. Another item we have are our micrometers. These are outside micrometers, so we might measure bearings or different items with this tool and spin it down and then read the measurement on the spindle here. Like I was talking about with those threads gauges, you might need to use a torque wrench on certain fasteners. Pretty much every fastener on an engine or an aircraft is going to have some kind of torque, either in foot pounds like this guy or inch pounds, which we also have inch pound torque wrenches. Lastly, a lot of the projects you may do at other portions outside of the hangar is electrical work, and we use multimeters for that. So we're going to use this guy to measure voltage, current, and resistance inside different electrical components. So these are pretty much some of the basic specialty tools, service items, or service tools that you may use while doing different projects in the program. Thank you guys for watching. This is the end of our video for our general toolboxes. If you did like the video, make sure you like, comment, share, and subscribe. And as always, never quit, never give up, and fly to the end.